In this how-to video for our vinyl, you're going to see how to customize a standard from the factory bike frame with satin red color change film. It begins, of course, with choosing the right tools, and they all come from our vinyl. Here you have a knife, squeegees with buffers on them. You'll also need knifeless tape. This is for cutting directly on the surface safely, and of course, cleaners. This rapid prep is for getting the surface ready for the install, and this one is for finishing the wrap so it's client ready. You always want to use highly absorbent microfiber towels. You'll need a tape measure at the beginning to make sure you have enough material to fit, and of course a heat gun to warm the film so it can stretch into place. An instructional guide comes with the kit from our vinyl. Bike frames naturally have a lot of oil that build up on them, so put extra focus on cleaning to ensure that the surface has a high surface energy and the wrap film can stick. Next up is to prep the frame with 3M knifeless tape. Here it's being placed at the front because the idea is to leave this exposed at the very end to highlight the logo and the color. Now here at the bottom of the bike frame, this is where there's going to be an overlap, so the pieces are going to be cut separate so it has good long-term hold. Because this is a direct cut on the body, knifeless tape is best. Now we measure the bike frame, make sure you have enough material left to right, top to bottom. Place the film on a work table that is clean with the liner side facing up. Once the piece is cut, remove the liner exactly halfway. And you could either have someone hold the frame for you at this moment or place it on a vise, then flip the panel over the top of the frame. Once it's set at the halfway point, now pick the frame up and lay it on the table. Using a squeegee with a buffer, lock the material on the top side of the frame. Then, for the front section, because this is the curviest, give it a little heat, then form it onto this wide section. One hand holds the material off the surface safely as the material is squeegeed into place. Once it's firmly here, then it can be fed back in towards the middle part of the frame. Now, go towards the front of the frame where the knifeless tape is, and take it just to that point. Make a relief cut here to access the knifeless tape, release the line, and then remove the excess film low and flat away. With the front of the frame locked in place, now the focus is on the middle section of the frame, from top to bottom. By working and stretching the material straight to this point, it'll help evenly distribute the film on the right and left of this area. Before focusing on those areas, secure it to the middle post. Once it's secure on this middle post, then put on an application glove and then form the film as far as you can without heat towards the inside portion of the upper area. Once the top section is set, now warm the film and stretch it evenly towards the right and left of the middle section. Once in place, use an application glove, in this case to form it around the middle part. Always pay attention to wrinkles and smooth them out, and as you can see with this material from our vinyl, it has airy-egress features, so bubbles and wrinkles are easily pushed away. Now here at the front, lock the material onto the table, come in with the squeegee and make a long squeegee stroke towards the front. Now the material sits in place so the inside portion is set, and now the material is relaxed towards the underside of the frame. Because the material is bunching up, make a relief cut so it can relax to the knifeless tape, which is then removed safely and cleanly without cutting directly on the frame. Now we move on to the left side. The material is relaxed just past the middle area, and for here, there's an open area, so a relief cut can be made, and this will make this section much easier to install. The material is cut flush to the back post, and now once everything is on the frame itself, areas in the middle can be cut safely away, and this will help form the film farther onto the inside portion. For this back area, the material is being float cut, which means a freehand pulls the excess film away, while the material is cut roughly a quarter inch past the edge. This then allows the film to be wrapped around with no tension and full coverage. And with the back section complete, now we move on to the large open section where the film is cut away, leaving 2 to 3 inches of film on all sides. Then it's formed into place using an application glove. Heat can be added to soften the film, and be sure to focus on the deepest corner areas first. These are what's called mouths. If you feed these first, there's less tension. Now here, the knife is cutting away the excess film once it's wrapped roughly to the other side of the frame. the blade is running alongside the bike frame, not on it. This means there's no direct cut on the surface. The key is the free hand creates nice even tension, and this means there'll be a nice straight edge on the underside. Speaking of the underside, here the excess film is being cut away safely next to the open gap. Same thing here. The free hand pulls away, the blade runs alongside the frame for a safe cut. The key is to always make sure the blade is sharp, so click it as many times as possible throughout the install. And now with one half of the frame wrapped, it's time for the other side. Flip the frame over, and it's very important to start the section correctly. Leave the backing paper on so there's uniform tension left to right, add heat, and now the film is flipped over the other side. Hold with even tension and then lock it in place. Once it's started correctly, remove the entire liner and install with the exact same protocol. Focus on the front first, then evenly stretch the film around the frame, form the film to the other side, which means the material overlaps on the inside portion of the frame. This means there's a very strong hold and the chance of it separating is very, very small, and the overlap edges disappear into the body lines. For this section, now float cut it so it wraps around as well. This means another strong overlap and good long-term hold. Here the excess film has been overlapped and now it's being cut away on the opposite side. Again, the blade is running next to the frame, not on it. And then it's immediately sealed for long-term hold. For the key areas where the hardware is going to go back onto the frame, always be sure to cut these out. If you put the hardware on top of the frame, it can cause the material to shift over time and actually come off the surface. So it's always a good idea to cut it flush, clean, and symmetrical so it looks super professional. So here at this section, always run the blade alongside the gap so it goes in nice and clean. Same thing for the top. And with everything cut out and sealed, the final step is to wipe it down with the aftercare cleaning product from our vinyl to make the finish pristine. And as you can see, with the right color change film and tools from our vinyl, and tips and tricks from the Rwraps Institute, you can create a beautiful finish and take a standard frame from the factory and customize it to one that truly suits you.